First up is this carrot top by Fiber Moods. I liked this because it seems so easy and quick, and I made sure everything was cut before starting this project. We begin here with the shoulder seams, sewing them with right sides together. After this is complete, we move on to our neckline, where we sew the two edges of the neck piece together, press the seam allowance open, and then slowly pin it to the neckline itself, matching the seam with the center back of the shirt. Next up, we're just sewing in the sleeve by matching the notches together, and we're sewing the side seam all together at once. So I toyed around with adding a zipper at the side seams just so this is breastfeeding friendly, but it was pretty oversized, so it was pretty unnecessary, and I just ended up sewing it together normally. Next up, we're just doing all of the hems, and then we're finished. This top took around an hour and a half to make, and I really loved this one. And this is the final look for the Clara top from Fiber Moods. I really love how big this is. It would also make a really cute dress, so maybe I make that option in the future. Next up is our EDT, and this is something I developed. I decided to hack this pattern by making the inside panel for the front to have a shelf bra, so I'm just turning back that seam allowance. Then we're going to clean finish the neckline and also the shoulder, and I decided to add elastic all over just to make this really durable, and this is just a little step here. So this is about a quarter of an inch wide, and I just zigzag all over that. So for the sleeve, I just like to sew in this really slowly. I made sure to add a lot of pins, and I'm sewing this with the sleeve pattern facing up so that I can make sure that nothing gets puckered when I'm sewing over this. This is just a really important step because you might have to remove it and take out a couple stitches just to fix this if you're sewing with the sleeve pattern down. Thing looked nice and neat. I just trimmed down all the extra seam allowances just to make the inside look really nice. And then the last here is just adding the inserts into the bralette. These are just from an old swimsuit that I had. I tacked it to the shelf, and then I am making sure that nothing gets sewn onto the exterior layer. And they're all done. Onto our swing short, we're sewing the front and back rises together with a quarter of an inch elastic to make it a little bit more durable. We move on to sewing the out seam as well as the inseam. Next, we move on to our waistband, where we sew the seam at the center back, press that seam allowance open, and fold it so to have the wrong side together. I'm matching all around so that everything is matching at the side seam and center back, and we sew everything around, leaving about 2 inches opening so we can insert the elastic. Next, we add a top stitch along the top of the waistband fold. This is for a little fold, a little ruffle at the top edge, and we insert the elastic in. Is a really great step to prevent your elastic from rolling, and we're just stretching and sewing down the center of the elastic. So we just move, stretch, sew, stretch. And after some final touches, this is the final result. So I really love this. I have an extra material, so I'm gonna make one more, and then we're gonna do some pattern testing for a swing short. And this is actually the swing short in a woven fabric, and we're moving on to this ruffle top. So I have here the ruffles, that's where I'm gonna start with, and with the right sides together, I'm just gonna sew all along the hem edge, and we're gonna clip that down before we flip it inside out. And I actually also ended up doing an edge stitching here. This helps prevent the lining or underside of the ruffle from rolling outwards. We're putting together the bodice, so we're marking the darts and sewing them for both the lining and outer material. The outside material for this fabric has a bit of a raised texture that I really loved, So that's why I chose this fabric, and I think it's also perfect for fall and really nice for layering. You can add like a little cardigan over this or even like a turtleneck underneath this. That's why I really like this option. When the darts are finished sewing, I also like to go in and trim down the seam allowance. This is just really nice and helpful to reduce bulk, and then I press everything open. After this, we're attaching the shoulder together. So this is for the lining and the outside fabric. And then we're gonna use a burrito method to sew the neckline and the armholes together for both the lining and the outer fabric. To begin, we're just going to sew all along the neckline, so all the way from the center back to the center front and back to the center back again. Then it's really important to cut almost down to that seam point and trim your seam allowances down. To our burrito method, we're going to take one side of the body and roll it to the other shoulder strap. So that strap is going to roll over, so creating a bit of a sandwich, and we're just going to encase that into the other side. So this is the right side together, and I'm pinning all the way from the armhole all the way down to the other armhole, and this is going to create a nice clean finish look. So for this, we're actually going to do the armhole, the full armhole, but also the back as well. So this is all clean finish, a nice, easy, quick step. We are clipping and trimming your seam allowance. And then for the best part is we're gonna flip this inside out so you can see all of your hard work. Like, you can now go and press this side, and then you just repeat it on the opposite shoulder. Step is we're going to sew the side seams together, so attaching the lining to the back lining and the front self to the back self. This is sewn in a bit of a circle, and you just repeat this for the right and left side. Next, we are adding that ruffle on the front, and with the right sides together, I'm just pinning everything in place. This ruffle will extend past the side seam and then meet at the center back. So at some point, you will not be pinning to anything. You will have some ruffle that goes off to the side. We are adding the larger ruffle to the bodice, and I'm just pinning to mark the center and the side seams so that everything matches up, and I'm giving this bigger ruffle a hem at the center back. I'm just adding the hem to the bottom ruffle, and this is a pretty big hem. This just helps to give body, and you can always obviously reduce or lengthen this. So the hem, I'm using a method of a blind stitch using my sewing machine. So you're setting your machine up for a zigzag, and then you turn the hem underneath like this, and then you have one zigzag go onto the self fabric, and then the other part of the zigzag get into the hem. This creates an invisible blind stitch hem using your machine. After this, we're adding the bigger ruffle to the actual bodice, and I'm just pinning in place and marking the center and the side seams just so that everything is nice and even. After this is done, we're able to pull on that white cord, and the ruffles just fall into place, and it looks really nice and beautiful. Ruffles are complete. We're just going to take our bias and fold it in towards the center like this. This is the side seam, and we're just going to attach this to the side ruffles so that we can tie this in the center back. After the bias is sewn onto the front, you're just going to turn down this bias taping and then sew it down so that it's securely hiding all of your seam allowance. Extend the sewing all the way down to the end of the tie, and you can turn the tie seam allowance inward so that everything is nice and clean finished. Last step is just to add the back straps and then also turn in the seam allowance of the lining and clean finish the ruffle hem, and then you're done. Please comment below, Cecilia, if this is something you're interested in making yourself. I'm going to be looking for pattern testers soon, and I would love for you to sew this yourself. last but not least is this suede skirt. So I found this at a secondhand store, and this is actually an upcycle. This is real suede, and this is going to be really easy to correct. So I just determined the length that I wanted. I wanted to reduce about 3.5 inches, and all you have to do is mark. I used some chalk and then just simply trimmed off the extra. And then for the lining, all you have to do is just hem that back. So it's about a finished length, about a half inch shorter than the suede itself. And this is the final look. I hope you really enjoy this one. Please like and subscribe if you like this content. Part 2 is coming soon. Thanks.